All right. Yeah, I mean, in a mirror like this, you'll keep almost any hand that has like four or more lands, almost no matter what the spells are. And it turns out these spells are okay. They're spells that do things. Hero's Downfall doesn't do much early, but the Murkrunker does. I mean, this is the matchup it's really for. Get that lifelink in there. And get to Evolving Wilds for an island and Bloodstained Mire for a swamp and end up being able to cast my spells in a reasonable manner. Opponent mulligan to six. Post-board games tend to be a little more interesting. Game one, there's just so little, there are so few cards that matter. Whereas post-board, there's a lot more action just because both players took out Bioblades that do nothing for at least like Ashiok's that do a lot. Right, let's get an island. I'm also a lot less worried about decking. Well, I guess I shouldn't be say I'm completely. I don't completely disregard decking just because you can still very easily get decked with when everyone's on a bunch of Ashiok's, but I'm a lot less concerned about it because you do have more ways to actually win the game. Not a lot more, but more. I didn't play Myra because I didn't want to thin my deck, and I'm not going to play Ashiok here because I don't want to get negated. Whereas if I just play a Murkrunker, if my opponent has a not a counter, a kill spell, then, and they use it on a Murkrunker, great. And if they don't, then the Murkrunker is going to just deal a bunch of damage. I would like to hit a fifth land so I can play Ashiok Negate or play Jace's Ingenuity. All right, another Ashiok. Interesting. So, what can my opponent play here? Opponent can play a counter. Yeah, given that I have double Ashiok and I don't have expectation of playing a land next turn, I'm just going to play this into a Dissolve or a Negate. Hopefully, a Negate. Yeah, getting negated is nice because it's one of the better cards and it's one of the cheaper cards, so. Much rather my opponent end up doing that. Alright, didn't get Jace Ingenuity'd or Sphinxed, which is nice, and I dual Radiant Fountain, which is even nicer. Alright, let's hit again, and I'm gonna Jace Ingenuity end of turn, not caring a ton whether it gets countered, but ready to start a fight. Oh, my opponent has one. I think I'm just gonna do the same, since it's way more mana efficient to use a 5 drop here, and I don't have to discard or anything, so drawing three is pretty nice. Ooh, those are some good ones. See, post board, you have cards that actually do things. Opponent, yeah, decent chance of thought seizing me. We'll have four thought seizes in the deck. I wouldn't mind a six untap mana here. Oh, here comes the thought seize. Oh, that's fine. If Ashiok goes, there's a chance this Murkrunker still threatens my opponent. And if my opponent goes take Thought Seize, Ashiok, Hero's Downfall, or Murkrunker, then I'll settle for the fact that I have three disruptive spells in hand and a scry land, and I'm getting a draw step right now. So, yes, I wish my opponent didn't have the card Thought Seize, because I have so many ways to protect Ashiok, but looks like they did. Interesting, they took the Thought Seize, so maybe they have a pearl-like Ancient in hand that they're very concerned about keeping, but I feel okay here. All right, let's play Ashiok with Negate up. I want to see if it resolves before playing my Temple of Deceit. All right, I'm gonna fight over this. I guess a Perilous Vault would be kind of annoying here. I will grant that. Declogate graveyards here, because why not? My opponent's my opponent. First of all, it's funny that my opponent's username is saying it sent you a message, and then. My opponent did comment me on a top deck, which is fine. and now, but I had both those cards. And my opponent said nice top deck, and I said I already had all the cards, like negate, and they're like, no, you top deck the negate, and it's like there's literally video evidence. So I don't mind that my opponent is is frustrated here. It's just funny. I have no ill feelings here, but they're now accusing me of lying. This is just the best. I don't know how I run into these characters. It is awesome. But when this video goes up, I will direct my opponent to it to just check it out, just see what they think, see if they're interested in it at all. All right. Looks like my opponent had the same thought on draw by Murkrunker. I need to hit a Murkrunker with Ashiok here. So far, I've hit some nonsense. Oh, Thoughtseize. All right, now let's play another Murkrunker. This way, I can have Dissolve and Downfall up, but also, more importantly, I don't, if my opponent kills the Murkrunker, I don't need to need to counter it or downfall my opponent's Murklurker. And because my opponent played a Murklurker, I'm not very worried about Perilous Vault. Though, to my opponent's credit, with the whole thinking that I top deck negate situation, there's sometimes Magic Online when you thought sees them just doesn't show all the cards. I thought they'd fix that, but, you know, I'm not taking that for granted. So it could be not my opponent's fault at all. They could have seen a window with four cards, taken the thought sees, and then not even seen the negate there. So that is a possibility. Also, I'm really not bothering attacking with these lurkers. I mean, I just do Prolic Ancient, which is nice, but there's just no need. I mean, I could attack with both, and my opponent could attack Ashiok back. I could even Heroes Downfall my opponent's Murklurker and attack, but none of that seems good. The question now is, will I counter a Dig? That seems interesting. Or a Jace's Ingenuity. Looks like a Dig through Time. Or an Ingenuity, who knows? Thing is, I get to cast Prolic Ancient, which is nice. But Jace's Ingenuity into three cards, I'm just going to counter that. I don't think I'm too close to wanting to play Prolic. Let's put a Swamp on the bottom. Just pass. Still think I don't really want a Downfall here. If I Downfall the Murklurker, I guess it makes it so if my opponent has Heroes Downfall, it doesn't matter as much, but it makes... Oh, there you go. See, I'm glad I didn't. It makes Perilous Vault a lot more annoying. If I Downfall Murklurker, then my opponent plays Perilous Vault, that's pretty bad for me. Jeez, are we just lurking all over the Murk? No, now our Hero's Downfalling. Alright. I will allow it. Draw, play Pluto Delta, pass the turn. Feeling fine here. I mean, opponent's on 6 lands and all spells, which is good, though... They're not able to play Prolic Ancient here, and I'm going to be able to play Prolic Ancient. And Prolic Ancient, I think, is going to be kind of nice. It's going to demand a response at some point, one way or the other. Alright, here comes the Ancient. I mean, I guess I would prefer to draw something like Dig Through Time, but I will settle for attacking with Prolic Ancient for now. And I guess I have 9 mana, so I can go ahead and lifelink it up. Well, it looks like it's going down. Alright, let's tap these, because I'm going to use these. Return Swamp. And play a Prolic Ancient. Still not sacking fetches. I mean, I scryed a card to the bottom. Like, I don't need to sack a fetch there. Alright. If my opponent had another Hero's Downfall, it would be kind of annoying. Looks like they might have a Dig Through Time. I mean, that's good here. Though, the clock is a real thing. And, I'm not particularly close to dying, though I guess my opponent's not all that close to dying either. Though the fact that I have a Prolic Ancient in play, my opponent doesn't, means that cards like Ashiok are just so much less impressive. Let's see what goes on here. So, Dig happens. Temple of Deceit apparently happens as well. Really don't want to return Prolic right now, because then I go up to, like, 9 cards in hand. 10 after I drew. Also, bouncing Prolic Ancient, then Thought Seizing is a effective way of getting rid of it. Alright, I'm afraid I have to. I just have nothing else going on. So, I'm going to bounce Prolic Ancient, even though I don't like the way this is going, but given that my hand doesn't do anything, seems like it is necessary. I'm a few turns away from playing it. Alright, let's play Temple of Deceit and discard some useless lands. Liliana Vess. Alright, I'll keep that there. Alright, no attacks. Discarding, I guess, a swamp and an island. I think Radiant Fountain's fine. I've got a lot of colored sources, so I don't mind just playing lands and passing. Yeah, if my opponent had followed up with like an Ashiok or something really annoying, then bouncing the Prolic could have been pretty bad for me, but they didn't. At some point I might want a Hero's Downfall, one of the Murklurkers. I just don't see that being the best way to win the game. I'm not going to play Liliana yet either. I just don't see a reason to do that, especially if my opponent goes end of turn Prolic. Alright, if they do, then I'm going to be... I think I kill it. Actually, I'm going to wait a turn. Just to double bounce it. Just to do basically the same thing. I can take a hit. It's not... I'm not going to die if I take six here. Yeah, I don't even really mind if my opponent gains some life. If we go to game three, I'm probably siding in more Merc Lurkers. Those signs of looters could be interesting here too. Draw. Alright, let's just play land. Let's pass. So another Prolic Ancient? Well, that forces my hand, I think. Alright. Well, let's Hero's Downfall, Prolic Ancient. Now I'm kind of in a tough spot. My opponent having the second one is actually very good for them, because now if they bounce one, then if I Hero's Downfall the second one, yeah, now they can just bounce it. So the question is now, do I Hero's Downfall it? They get to just bounce three and then replay it, but I guess I'm in the same spot. All right, I think I just do it now. I actually got to watch out to make sure I've got enough lands to fetch too. Got one each of Island and Swamp left. All right, let's kill the other Pearl Lake. A little less satisfying because it didn't, because the other one didn't get bounced, but I think this is still okay. The other thing I don't want to run into is I don't want my opponent to counter the Hero's Downfall and then end up in a situation where I have a Pearl Lake Ancient, but I'm tapped out, my opponent has one and can play a spell to get prowess, or just kill mine and end up killing me. Now my opponent plays a 7th land and passes. I'm going to play my 7th land and pass. They're going to play Prolic Ancient. I'm going to play Prolic Ancient. And we're going to go from there. Murderous Cut actually seems kind of good here. I wouldn't mind having a Murderous Cut. Are we just main phasing Prolic Ancient? No, we're just sacking to speed things up. That's fine. Radiant Fountain. Pass the turn. It's kind of annoying that I can't... block my opponent's Prolic Ancient with mine because of prowess, because even if I put like a Merc Lurker and a Prolic Ancient on my opponent's Prolic Ancient or double block, if my opponent goes like Hero's Downfall your Prolic Ancient, then I just lose it all, and that seems kind of bad. But I guess they only have one Hero's Downfall left. No, they have none. They're out of Hero's Downfalls. Well, that's interesting. Oh, okay, I like this. This is much better, because now I get to play my Prolic Ancient. If they don't have a Murderous Cut here, then I think I'm in good shape. If they have Murderous Cut, it actually could be kind of bad for me. But they know I have Prolic Ancient, so they kind of have to. Oh, they don't? Okay, well, now I just get to make some awesome blocks. I'm not sure exactly what this plan is. I mean, unless my opponent's got something... like a trumpet blast or something. They just lost a bunch of creatures. And now I get to crack back for more and gain a bunch of life. So, yeah, that didn't make a ton of sense. Like a post-combat Drown in Sorrow? No? That would be bizarre. Alright, Merc Lurker I will allow. Attack. Probably just attack with these and then just do some lifelinking. Alright, the block that makes sense. Draw by Merc Lurker targeting Pearl Lake Ancient. That is. And actually, maybe I should play Liliana first, because I actually do want to play. I could play Liliana here and tutor immediately, and then opponent would have to attack with Pearl Lake Ancient to kill Liliana, and then I tutor for like a Silence of Believers or something like that. Yeah, I guess that actually seems better than doing nothing else. Alright. Actually, let's first play Temple, because I want to scry something to the top or bottom, and then, well... Basically, I didn't want to play Liliana, then play a Temple one after tutoring. That doesn't make any sense. So I wanted to do it this way, though. I guess if I'm tutoring, it doesn't make any sense either, so yeah. Basically, I should have just played a different land, I think, is the conclusion to that. Search my library for a card. And I actually do think that that card. I mean, it could be just be Dig Through Time. Actually, Dig Through Time sounds even better. It's just two mana and finds, you know, two relevant spells. Let's take a stop off my end step. I don't need that anymore. I'm not really beating my opponent in terms of damage because my opponent still has a Murk Lurker, despite their best efforts, and is going to go ahead and gain at least six life off Prolic Ancient here. But if we're doing this, then it's still better for me. Especially since I'm drawing a Dig Through Time. Even my opponent's out of Hero's Downfalls. And it's not even clear if my opponent... I guess they have Murderous Cut, which is better than Silence, but it's not clear they have a ton more removal besides what they've already used. So really don't have a ton more draw by Murk Lurkers. All right, I should board in four here. All right, well, I won the match, and still very amusing to me. Interesting way to kick off a career playing blue-black, but hey, I'll take it.